I have seen Southbank Gamelan players using note. Do they use notes in Indonesia when they are playing gamelan?
Some people do. Some people use notations. Because it depends on their knowledge. For example, if they're not good, they don't have much knowledge about gamelan music, and they have to play very long pieces, for example, and yeah, I presume that they might need to use notations, or maybe if they have to play some pieces that they've never ever played before. Yeah, there are thousands and thousands of gamelan pieces. Yeah.
Apart from joining Southbank, do you join any other groups in the UK?
I used to play with a group called Laras Laris. It's a gamelan garden group. And we were only like eight members in a group, and we did some performances in many occasions, like wedding parties or conferences, and yeah. And
Laras Laris, I've never heard of this group. Where is the group based, and who are they? Who are the members?
We don't really play together anymore. But sometimes we if we have anyone asking us for playing in a party or so, then we just get some people together.
And okay, who are these people, and who formed the group?
The group Laras Laris is actually the members of Laras Laris were actually some members from the Gamelan Southbank Gamelan Players, but we don't really play together anymore. I suppose that because everyone's so busy and everyone lives from different parts of the UK, and we don't really try to find any performances anymore. Like
who formed the group?
The idea came from some people from the Southbank Gamelan groups, like Pete Smith and Jonathan Roberts and me and Nikhil Dali.
And yeah. What gamelan were they playing?
We played traditional gamelan pieces, Japanese traditional gamelan repertoires, and using just few instruments like in there. Rebab, gambang, kendang, just enough for eight or ten people. I think less than 10 people.
So you since when have you been teaching at school in the UK?
Since I came to this country in 1999, yeah, I did. My first gamelan project was in outside London. I think it's in three different places. Hastings and East Essex, basically. Hastings, Cobra, and can't remember the other one. It's in three different places in East Essex.
How do you feel teaching kids? They are not Indonesian. How are they coping?
It's great. I mean, I don't really see the differences teaching children in any other countries. But I think teaching children in these countries has been so great. I mean, yeah, sometimes you find you have to deal with some difficult children, but mostly they good behavior and they appreciate the music very much. That's a good thing.
Anything else you would like to say in terms of playing gamelan? Would you encourage people to play gamelan?
I compose music for gamelan and any other instruments. that might be an interesting subject.
Yeah.
composing music is part of my life. I started to compose music when I was a music student in Indonesia, and using many different instruments, and instruments that I could think of, and gamelan is one of the exciting instruments that I always use in my compositions, and started composition seriously at the Guildhall. I took a master's in composition at the Guildhall. Then I just finished my PhD in composing music at York University, composing music for gamelan, Western and electronics music. And I think gamelan music is kind of endless source of endless inspiration for me, for my composition, because of the tunings, because of the sonority of the instruments, and as well as technique of playing the instruments. It's kind of gives me so much ideas for my compositions.
When you're composing these pieces of music, do you need other players to play with you?
Yes, of course, yes.
How do you combine?
I have also write some pieces for the solo performer that just one musician.
How do you combine gamelan and the Western music? How do you compose them together?
I think firstly that you have to know the character of both instruments, the gamelan and Western instruments. For example, if you compose a piece for kendara and violin, for example, you have to make sure that you know the tuning system. For example, in gamelan, you don't have the diatonic tuning, like when you play violin or piano, you have a diatonic tuning. So basically, when you collaborate those two different instruments, Western and gamelan, so it's kind of combining two different tuning systems, diatonic and gamelan tuning, which is sometimes a bit tricky. So you have to know both tunings very well, and usually in composing music for in collaborating these two different instruments, usually I have one common key, for example, and gamelan. Key number 6, for example, in gamelan, is equal to B natural or B flat. It depends on what gamelan you use. So that's kind of guidance note, yeah, that I can use for composing music, for combining, for collaborating these two instruments, these two different instruments.
So far you've been composing Western music with Javanese gamelan. Have you composed with other gamelan?
In the past, I've done some projects using different gamelan instruments, not just Javanese, but also Balinese instruments for compositions. But I don't really write at the moment. I don't have any pieces for specific gamelan instruments, for specific Balinese instruments, for example, and Western instruments, for example. I haven't done that yet, but I've done some projects using Balinese instruments, composition projects, but not for my own composition.
Have you ever played Sundanese gamelan?
Sundanese gamelan, I'm not quite sure, actually. I must have tried one or twice playing Sundanese gamelan, but I can't really remember. No.